The commanding general of the U.S. Army Combined Arms Center in Fort Leavenworth, Kansas, Lieutenant General Milford Beagle, visited the Defense Language Institute Foreign Language Center in Presidio of Monterey for the first time July 17, where he observed Korean language classes and spoke with military leadership and cadre about the foreign language mission.
그래서 아마 개구리는 나쁜 것을 대변한 것이에요.
Impressed with student fluency, Beagle explained that he was stationed in Korea and had a good sense for how complicated the language is to learn.
And I don't understand probably 90% of what you're saying, but very, very fluid just from being there and being in the environment.
Beagle was stationed in Korea twice, and on both occasions, he had the opportunity to learn some Korean and interact with his counterparts.
We go to other countries or, you know, other nations, and whether it be in combat or not, we learn enough to be useful but not helpful. And listening to those students, I mean, what they're learning is going to be very helpful, not only for them but for their unit and then for our larger enterprise in the Army in terms of what they bring to the table, just because they know and understand the language at such a high level. And there's things that you don't want to have lost in translation. And even when we speak the same language, there's a lot that can be lost. But now, when you're not in your own environment, you have someone that can fill that void to where you don't lose, you know, anything in translation, literally, that means a lot. And that shows the importance of having the language training that we do have and the skill sets that are resident, you know, here in order to impart that on our students.
When asked what advice he would give students in their future careers, Beagle said,
because, you know, given the amount of time they will stay here and the amount of effort and energy they put into getting good at their skill, just like any other soldier at any other, you know, training installation, they're going to put in a lot of time. And it's that effort that I saw today that just made me, you know, very optimistic, very hopeful about all things in our Army, because you see what excellence looks like every single day, and seeing it here in a snapshot in the classrooms, that's excellent. So it's not only just meeting the standard, they're exceeding the standard in terms of what they're learning and then just the immersion environment that they're in. And whether it's, you know, about them staying in the military or leaving, it's all about repetition. And repetition, which they see here a lot, breeds confidence. And confidence breeds competence. And competence breeds mastery. So they see that cycle here. And whether they leverage it in an Army career or outside of the Army, I mean, it's always going to go back to the work you put in for the repetition, and it's going to gain you everything else that you need, not only whether you wear the cloth of our nation or not, it's going to bring you other things in life because you put in the work at the very beginning, and it's just going to gain you so much more over time.
DLIFLC courses last between 36 and 64 weeks. The Korean course is 64 weeks long, nearly 15 months. Instruction takes place 5 days a week, 6 to 7 hours per day, with 2 to 3 hours of homework each evening. For the military, it is one of the longest training pipelines.